बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम. ओ माय लॉर्ड, ओपन माय हार्ट, मेक माय टास्क इजी फॉर मी एंड अनटाई द नॉट फ्रॉम माय टंग सो दैट दे मे अंडरस्टैंड माय स्पीच. टुडे आवर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज सेविंग इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द ओपन इकॉनमी, राइट? विद वर्चुअली नो एक्सेप्शन, मॉडर्न इकॉनमीज आर ओपन इकॉनमीज, which means that we engage in international trade of goods and services, in international borrowing and lending, right? Why do countries sometimes borrow abroad to pay for an excess of imports over imports? But at other times, imports more than they exports and lend the difference to other countries. Why doesn't each country just balance its book and import as much as it exports each other? As we explained in this chapter, the fundamental determinants of countries' trade positions are the country's saving and investment decision. There's although the issues of trade balances and international lending introduced here may seem at first to be unrelated to the topics covered in last chapter, the two sets of questions actually are closely linked. Like to explore how desired national saving and desired investment health determines the pattern of international trade and lending, we extend the ideas of good market equilibrium described by the saving investment diagram to include a foreign sectors. We show that unlike the situation in a closed economy in last chapter, in an open economy, desired national saving and desired investment don't have to be equal. Instead, we show that when a country desired national saving exceeds its desired investment, the country will be a lender in international capital market and will have current account surpluses. Similarly, when a country desired national saving is less than its desired investment, the country will be an international borrower and will have a current account deficit. The learning objective of this chapter is how the balance of payment is calculated, goods market equilibrium in an open economy. Then we will discuss the factor that affects saving and investment and determines that current account balancing in a small open economy, and the factor that affects saving and investment and determine the current account balances in a large open economy. First, we will discuss balance of payment. Examining the factor that affect international trade and lending first requires an understanding of the basic of balance of payment accounting. The balance of payment accounts, which are part of national income accounts discussed in chapter 2, are the record of countries' international trade. It is a record of a country's international transactions consists of current account and capital account. Okay, the current account measures country's trade in currently produced goods and services along with unilateral transfers between countries. For convenience, we divide the current account into three separate components. First is net exports of goods and services. Second is net income from abroad. And the third is net unilateral transfers. What is net exports? Net exports is the concept of, like we have discussed in last chapter, exports minus imports. As a part of expenditure report to measure GDP in chapter 2, here we point out the net exports often are broken into two categories. First is merchandise goods and second is services. Merchandise consists of currently produced goods. Goods the difference between a country's merchandise exports and its merchandise import is called merchandise trade balance. Internationally traded services include transportation, tourism, insurance, education, and financial services. So, this is a category. If you can see that goods and services, export of goods and services are 2,105. It's an arbitrary hypothetical data we have taken from the book. Now we will discuss net income. Net income from abroad. Net income from abroad equals income receipts from abroad minus income payment to residents of the country. It is almost equal to net factor payment from abroad, we discussed in chapter 2. We will ignore the difference between NFP and net income from abroad and treat the two as equivalent concept. The income receipts from flowing into a country, which are credit item in the current account, consist of compensation received from resident working abroad plus income, investment income from assets abroad. The income payment flowing out of a country, which are debit item in the current account, consists of compensation paid to foreign residents working in the current country plus payment to foreign owners of assets in the country. Okay, then now we'll discuss net unilateral transfers. Unilateral transfers are the payment from one country to another country that do not correspond to the purchase of any goods, services, or assets. Examples are official foreign aids, a payment from one government to another. Sometimes we consider gift of money from residents of one country to family country living in another country. When Pakistan makes a transfer to another country, the amount of transfer is a debit item because funds flow out of Pakistan, right? Adding all the credit items and in current account balance, how you get the current account balance, adding all the credit items and subtracting all the debit items in the current account yield a number called the current account balance. If the current balance is positive, account balance is positive, the value of credit items exceed the value of debit items, the country has a current account surplus. If the current account balance is negative, with the value of debit item exceeding the value of credit item, the country has a current account deficit. Right? This is the, you can see numerical value of net income from abroad, which is net factor payment, income received from abroad. It's 738.7 million or billion, or income payment to the residents of the country. If you take the difference, you will get the 221. Okay. You can see the current account balance calculation. Again, it's a hypothetical data taken from the book. The current account balance is divided three categories. First is net exports of goods and services. Second is net income from abroad and net unilateral transfers. This goods and services or furtherly divide into two major heads, like in terms of export and import. You can see that the goods and services are calculated in different heads. So if you see the country's export is 1,497.5 and the services export is 600 something. If you add up these two values, you can get 2,105. The imports of the country is like first you import goods, which is in your credit item, subtract, that's why it has a negative sign. 2023 5.7, and the services imported imports are 429. If you add these two values, you will get 2665 million rupees or whatever. This is the net income from abroad. Income received from abroad is 738.7. Income payments to resident of other countries 517. If you take the difference, you will get 221.1. And let's assume that net unilateral transfers, the gifts you get from other country is 134.5. If you add 560 and 134.4.6, you will get around 694.6. But if you subtract this 221.1, you will get 473 something. Next, we will discuss capital account balance in second video.